You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures, and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the field of science and technology, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Usma Jafri, and today in our episode of My India, we will take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. To commemorate the living heritage of Indian dance, sculpture and art, a number of festivals are organized throughout the year. Konark Festival of Odisha, that recently observed its 30th edition, is among these occasions that take place in the backdrop of Mammoth Sun Temple. The 8th edition of the International Sand Art Festival was also hosted simultaneously, enabling visitors to witness both these brilliant showcases of art at the same time.
Decked up with colourful lights and glittery artistic pieces, the exquisite open-air auditorium, situated in the backdrop of Konark Sun Temple, was casting a magical spell on the visitors. Popularly known as Natya Mandir, the auditorium is famous for playing host to Konark Dance Festival every year. Jointly organized by Odisha Tourism and Odissi Research Center since 1989, the 5-day cultural extravaganza aims to boost tourism in Konark along with preserving and increasing the reach of Indian folk dance forms.
Konark Dance Festival हमारी कंट्री का वन ऑफ द ओल्डेस्ट डांस फेस्टिवल्स है और आज के दिन में इसको नंबर वन फेस्टिवल के हिसाब से देखा जाता है देश में तो इसका फॉर्मेट ये रहता है कि प्रत्येक दिन हम दो क्लासिकल डांस परफॉर्म करते हैं एक तो ओडिसा वो होता है और एक दूसरा तो कभी मणिपुरी कभी कथक कभी भरतनाट्यम तो उस हिसाब से और हमारी चेष्टा ये रहती है कि हम देश के और देश के बाहर से भी जो उस स्पेसिफिक डांस के जो some of the most renowned dancers, we invite them to perform.
This year too, the event saw some heart-touching choreographies in classical dance forms. The ensemble in Kathak, mentored by established dancers Kumudini Lakhia from Ahmedabad, grabbed maximum eyeballs. The performance began with an ode to Goddess Durga, followed by a reverberating demonstration of Tatkar, the skill of footwork in Kathak, and accompanied by recitals in Tal Dhamar.
हमारा पहला साल था इस बार कोणार्क में महोत्सव में परफॉर्म करने के लिए तो पूरी टीम हम लोग we were all looking forward to perform क्योंकि इतने सालों में हमने इतने वीडियोस इतने शोज टीवी पे हर जगह देख चुके थे तो हमें पता था कि यहाँ पे क्या एक्सपीरियंस होने वाला है बट यहाँ आने के बाद ही हमें आइडिया लगा कि कितना ग्रैंड था नॉट ओनली द स्टेज एक एक्सपीरियंस होता है जो आप स्टेज पे होते हैं बट एक जर्नी होती है जो आप ऑडियंस के साथ शेयर करते हैं क्योंकि जब भी आप स्टेज पे आते हैं आप शुरुआत में ये सोचते हैं कि इस जर्नी में अपने ऑडियंस को साथ में लेके जाना है सो इट वॉज अ ग्रेट एक्सपीरियंस वी फील ब्लेस्ड टू बी परफॉर्मिंग जहाँ पे इतने अच्छे अच्छे कलाकार ऑलरेडी परफॉर्म कर चुके हैं
Another thrilling performance was in Odissi that was performed by a troupe mentored and choreographed by world-renowned Odissi guru Ranjana Gohar from New Delhi. The presentation began with the depiction of the mythological tale of Lord Vishnu's first among the Dash Avatar, the Matsya Avatar, to retrieve the Vedas from the demon Hayagriva. The choreography brought out the devotion and grace of Odissi, very well defining traditional aspects and touch of creativity.
today it was the best one. Oh, Odyssey, very, 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 very nice. And also Kathak, the performers are very, very strong. And the all together, the music was very good music, very, very perfect.
मैं कोणार्क कई बार आ चुका हूँ और हमेशा आके ऐसा महसूस होता है कि इंडिया की सबसे ज़्यादा प्रेस्टिजियस स्टेज लगती है मुझे ये और दो दो तीन तीन दिन रुककर हम परफॉर्मेंसेस भी देखते हैं यहाँ पर और मुझे नहीं लगता ऐसा कोई स्टेज हो सकता है
Alongside Konark Festival, International Sand Art Festival also captured major attention of the crowd at the Chandrabhaga Beach. Over 100 artists from various countries like the United States, Japan, Spain and Sri Lanka participated in the festival who left the visitors spellbound with their well-carved sand sculptures. During the five-day festival, sand arts on the ongoing Men's Hockey World Cup and sand sculptures showing cultures of various countries and states were on display.
And I first time I'm visiting the sand festival and I'm very impressed by the work. The Indians have done a beautiful job and I saw a few of the foreigners too. They're doing their best, but I think the Indian ones are far superior.
In these many years, both the Konark Festival as well as the International Sand Arts Festival have carved out a niche of their own in the country's annual carnival calendar by providing a wonderful opportunity to the budding artists to make their presence felt on the international performing arts arena.
Mass weddings are fast becoming a new integral part of India's multi-religious society. Besides being economical, these marriages also present a great example of unity and brotherhood as couples from different sections of society tie the sacred knot together under one roof. This unification of diverse faiths was recently witnessed at a mass wedding in Moradabad city of Uttar Pradesh. Have a look.
In a simple yet unique show of communal harmony, as many as 52 underprivileged couples belonging to both Hindu and Muslim communities tied the nuptial knot at a mass wedding ceremony organized in Moradabad under the state's Chief Minister Mass Wedding Scheme. Beautifully dressed up in traditional attires, the couples performed several wedding rituals in the presence of their family and friends. The religious gurus coming from various faiths supervised and conducted all the marriages according to the rituals espoused in different religions. Strengthening the thread of secularism, all the couples exchanged the vows under the same roof.
51 जोड़ों की शादी का लक्ष्य रखा था जिसमें लक्ष्य से ऊपर 52 जोड़े चिन्हित किए गए जो मुख्यमंत्री जी का दिशा निर्देश है जिसमें पात्र लोग जो धन के अभाव में शादी विवाह सही से नहीं कर पाते उनके लिए एक समायोजित तरीके से एक स्थान निश्चित करके यहां पे उन जोड़ों का विवाह आज संपन्न कराया गया है गरीब लोगों का इसमें लाभ हो जिसमें ना धर्म जाति कोई इसमें दिशा नहीं रखा गया है कि हमारे यहां पे 22 मुस्लिम जोड़ों ने भी शादी की है 30 जोड़े इसमें हिंदू रहे हैं तो इसमें ना धर्म का ना जाति का किसी को महत्व नहीं दिया गया जो पात्र है जो गरीब है जो निर्धन है जिसको इसकी आवश्यकता है उसे इस योजना से लाभान्वित कराया गया
The atmosphere was full of gaiety and warmth which was very well reflecting on the faces of the young brides and grooms Besides making all the wedding arrangements the couples were even handed a check of rupees 20,000 along with basic commodities like kitchen essentials and other household items to start their new life Lunch was also arranged for all the guests as the part of the ceremony. Couples were full of praise for the state government for making such wonderful arrangements for their marriage.
बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है, अच्छी बात है उन्होंने सब लोगों की गरीब लोगों की शादी कराई है.
Besides reducing the worries of financial implications among the parents or guardians of the brides, mass wedding ceremony beautifully showcased the conglomeration of the wide range of Indian cultures and communities, displaying unity and oneness present among the people of India amidst the diversity.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Over 40 companies from across the world participated in a tool and machine exhibition recently organized in Rajkot city of Gujarat. The four-day exhibition saw hundreds of participants in the event. International investors saw India as a potential market for the growth of CNC, computer numerical control, companies.
We have been exporting our machines to 140 countries in the world. And for the future plan, maybe I think next year, our plan is to register our own branch office in India. And of course, this is also to help us to work more closely with our local partner and to bring the best laser cutting solution for Indian market.
Many latest products, including laser cutting machines and car parts, were also on display at the exhibition. Students from schools and engineering colleges also visited the exhibition. Reportedly, $20 billion worth of machine tools are produced in India, making the country a sizable place for investment. A fleet of vintage motor cars and bikes recently hit the streets of Lucknow city as a part of annual vintage car exhibition, presenting a spectacle for the residents. The rally was flagged off from the vintage motor exhibition by the district magistrate of the region, Kaushal Raj Sharma, and was organized as a part of the ongoing Lucknow Mahotsav.
50 se bhi upar isme karein aur motorcycles shamil hain. अधिकतर जो गाड़ियां हैं वो 80-90 साल पुरानी हैं और यहां पे बहुत ही हम लोग कोशिश करते हैं हर साल की इनको शोकेस किया जाए लखनऊ के लोग इसको अप्रिशिएट कर सकें.
As per reports, the vehicles that took part in the show were 1935 Fiat Balela, 1911 model Meriwether car, 1926 Brand Austin hit the road first, Ford Roadster, Austin 6, Chevrolet Phaeton, Morris, Jaguar, Humber, Singer Bentham, Fiat, Ford Custom and other vintage models of Austin, Ford, Morris and Chevrolet. Adrenaline junkies from across the globe recently thronged Prime Minister Modi's home state of Gujarat to be a part of MRF MO Grip FMSCI National Supercross Championship, which took place on the muddy tracks at the Akota Stadium. Around 150 riders from Madhya Pradesh, Goa, Cochin, Coimbatore and other parts of the country participated in the Vadodara leg of the tournament. The highlight of the championship was freestyle motocross riders from Australia, Jordan Sprague and Sean Webb, performing their widely renowned stunts on the tracks, piquing the crowd's interest even further.
We're very excited to be here. We heard the Bharatiya crowd is very, very wild, very, very loud, so we're excited to be here.
Apart from the usual riders, 16-year-old rider Tanishka Shanbog, the only girl in tournament, and a 7-year-old Viraj Rathore, the youngest rider, were also part of the championship. A unique and extraordinary campaign recently came to notice in Mayurbhanj district of Odisha, where a 36-year-old educated boy, Bishnu Bhagat, in his unique style is spreading silent messages to society regarding polythene eradication. Popular as Chalta Firta Dustbin in his district, Bishnu covers up himself with a dress of plastic and garbage with few placards clinched to his bicycle that he rides here and there to show up his positive intentions towards society silently. He specially goes to schools where he shares his thoughts about the harmful effects of plastics with young children, as he believes they can play a great role in disseminating this message.
बच्चे ही हमारे अगले भविष्य हैं जो कि पॉलिथीन को मुक्त कर सकते हैं और अपने अपने मम्मी पापा को भी बोलेंगे कि पॉलिथीन यूज मत कीजिए कॉटन बैग यूज कीजिए सामान लाते बाजार जाते हैं तो अपने घर से बैग लेके जाइए.
Bhagat started this campaign where he once witnessed the death of cow due to the regular consumption of plastic. This incident left a great impact on his life and he decided to start up a campaign so that he can at least lessen the use of plastic if he cannot stop it.
Today in our section of Asia Buzz, we will see how Japan's All Nippon Airways continue to offer traditional Japanese food to its passengers through its Taste of Japan initiative. It recently introduced food from Shugoku and Shikoku regions of the country. Also, Tokyo Metropolitan Government continues to make efforts to keep the city clean by recycling waste with innovative methods. Take a look.
Traditional Japanese foods, collectively known as washoku, is prepared by using ingredients from different parts of Japan. Chukoku and Shikoku regions of Japan contribute largely to produce many ingredients used in cooking washoku. All Nippon Airways, or ANA, has recently announced its new in-flight menu, which consists of many local dishes. The Taste of Japan by ANA project aims to attract foreign tourists by promoting cuisines from Japan's traditional meals. It includes food, drinks, sweets, and culture.
第1弾、主に地方のいろんな魅力を情報発信していくというところを中心にやっておりましたけれども、第2弾につきましては、そこにとどまらず、航空券、あるいは旅行商品、それから県産品の購入等々ですね、ANAグループ横断的に総力を挙げて、地元の魅力を発信をして、そしてお客様に来ていただけるような取り組みを
Such initiative by ANA is helping to promote tourism in various prefectures of Japan. It helps to promote the indigenous food and culture. The officials from Okayama Prefecture appeal to passengers to relish local meal and enjoy culture. The officials from Okayama Prefecture appeal to passengers to relish local meal and enjoy the culture.
Hey,皆さんこんにちは。ご紹介をいただきました岡山県東京事務所長の牧雄でございます。 清水白桃をぜいたくに使用したソルベペーシュと呼ばれるデザートが提供されると伺っております。機内でこれをお召し上がりになられたお客様が、よし今度はぜひ岡山に行って、麦立ての清水白桃を食べてみようと、そんなふうに思っていただけるんじゃないかなというような、そんな期待も膨らんでおるところでございます。
At the venue, staff of the tourism office provides information about food served as in flight meal.
今訪日の観光のお客様は非常に伸びておりまして、上位10カ国の中でもアジアの国が大半を占めているわけですけれども、その中でも今東南アジア、ベスト10の中に4カ国多分入っているというふうに思いますけれども、非常に今たくさんの方が来られているというと同様に、同時にですね、非常に伸びも急激に伸びておりまして、これからますます東南アジア各国から日本を訪れていただくお客様の数の増加っていうのは大きく期待されているところです。 なので、そういうお客様に対して、本当にその日本のいろんな観光地、各地の魅力をお伝えをしてですね、ますますこう日本に興味を持っていただいて、そして訪れていただいて、日本を好きになっていただくと、そういう流れをもっともっと作っていけるように、私どもお手伝いをさせていただきたいというふうに思っています。The
All Nippon Airways is not only helping to promote the food and culture of Japan, but is also promoting tourism in the country. Next, we will talk about the sincere efforts being made by the Tokyo Metropolitan Government Bureau to recycle the wastewater and keep the city clean. Shibora Water Reclamation Center is the third oldest water reclamation center in Tokyo. A part of the treated water is cleaned through sand filtration and then used inside the center for cleaning facilities, cooling machines, and flushing toilets. The generated sludge is pumped through pressure pipelines to the Nanbu sludge plant for treatment.
こちらの水が、現在のこの反応層の中の水を、採取したものになります。で、この水の中に微生物が、入っておりまして、その微生物の力を借りて水を、きれいにしているところです。
With the use of microorganism, the dirt sinks to the bottom and water is gradually cleaned up. In a secondary sedimentation tank, activated sludge masses formed in the reaction tank are precipitated for 3 to 4 hours, resulting in the separation of a supernatant or treated water and sludge.
The water, which was originally sewage, is processed and thus become clean.
東京都下水道局では、こちらの施設を利用しまして、再生水を製造しております。で、再生水の原料は、下水処理施設の中の第二沈殿池、こちらの上澄みの水、こちらを原料として活用しております。One
of features of Shibora Water Reclamation Center is reclaimed water utilization project contributing to recycling-oriented city. There is large volume of treated water with stable water quality, so it can be used effectively as reclaimed water. A reclaimed water production facility operates with ceramic used in filtering material in reclaimed water treatment process. This helps meet growing demand for such as toilet water.
私たちが生活していく中で、水は欠かせない資源だというふうに思っております。使用された水をきれいにして、そしてそれをまた利用する。こういった水の再利用の循環を通じまして、例えば水不足に悩んでいる地域の方々ですとか、そういったところでの活用も期待ができるところだと思います。Efforts
of Tokyo Metropolitan Government are praiseworthy for its commitment towards providing safe recycled water.
Renowned poet Kefi Azmi once said, "I have traveled across the globe, but India, in my eyes, is the epitome of coexistence and love people have for each other, despite the fact that almost everything about them is different." These words of Azmi beautifully portray India's picture to the whole world. So, giving you a glimpse of it, today we take you to a small town in the West Bengal's Bankura district, where people of all castes and communities live together with peace and harmony. A report.
Situated in the Bankura district of West Bengal, Beliator is a small town known for the strong bond of brotherhood that exists between different communities living here. This bond can be very well seen at the different workplaces of the town that mainly consist of tailoring industries and provides livelihood to several people from different faiths. The people employed in these industries not just work together, but also share a unique bond of friendship with each other. Irrespective of the fact that some of them are Hindu by religion and others Muslim, their daily routine is almost similar. They even share their meals, attend each other's festivities, and live like one large family.
Total, amnar amar 28 bochor ei line ta holo.
Mane kormi total royeche
na. Total ekhon 6 jon achi.
উপার্জন
মোটামুটি আমার এখান থেকে করছে সবাই সব নিজেরা ভাই ভাইয়ের মতনই আছি আপনার কোনো অসুবিধা হয়নি
এই এলাকায় সম্প্রীতি কোনো অসুবিধা নেই এই বেলেতোড় এলাকা খুব শান্তশিষ্ট এলাকা এবং হিন্দু মুসলিম এরা আমরা মিলেমিশে থাকি পাশাপাশি থাকি এবং প্রত্যেকের বাড়িতে অনুষ্ঠান আমার বাড়িতে পুজো ওর বাড়িতে বিয়ে বাড়ি এইসব জলসা টলসা সবেতেই আমরা যাতায়াত করি
এইখানে আমরা পিকনিক করে খাওয়া দাওয়া সবে একসাথেই থাকি ওটা কোনো অসুবিধা হয় না আমিও রান্না করে খাই উনিও রান্না করে আমিও খাই
কেমন লাগে
আমাদের খুব আনন্দ জিনিস আমরা এক মিলেমিশে থাকি বলে আমাদের আনন্দ লাগে
This is the real picture of coexistence in India, where people believe in mutual love, shared respect, and have regards for each other's beliefs. Even though it has faced numerous challenges time and again, India's unity and extreme diversity continues to strive and only grows with every new challenge.
A dream doesn't become a reality through magic. It takes sweat, hard work, and determination. This quote by Colin Powell perfectly encapsulates the life of 24-year-old Radhita Roy from Kolkata, who recently won the prestigious international photography competition held in UAE. Roy, who once started her journey by borrowing her cousin's HD camera as she couldn't afford to buy it, has today become an inspiration for millions of small towners who dream to achieve big in their life.
From clicking real-time photos in Kolkata to exhibiting her photographs at Exposure Exhibition in UAE Sharjah City, a small town girl, Ranita Roy from Kolkata's Andul has come a long way ahead. It is only her passion for photography that has made her reach to this international exhibition where veteran war photojournalist Sir Don McCullen even tipped her for the top.
There's nothing nicer than meeting a nice human being for a change who happens to have some talent, but they're not sure, and it has to be brought out of them. It can only be done by encouragement.
Photography, you know, taking pictures, it gives me happiness. It's kind of meditation.
Giving a glance at the various technical aspects of her photographs, McCullen even hails Roy as a rising star of photography.
If I was her, she lives near one of the greatest cities in India, it's Calcutta. It's a city I have very close to my heart, and I've been many times. I can tell you now, you see humanity struggling for life there on a scale you wouldn't dream of thinking about.
4 years ago, Roy, who had to try really hard to convince her father about her love for photography, is today one amongst the winners of Timothy Allen Photography Scholarship Award, which is run at the annual Exposure Exhibition and is attended by the world's most prominent exponents. Last week only, she went to collect the award, and it was for the first time that she left India. Roy, who describes herself as a small-town girl with big dreams in her eyes, is now all set for a journey to become a world-famous photographer.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at suggest.myindia@gmail.com. I'm your host, Uzma Jafri, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.